morning, student. Today we will study Unit 2, Chapter 1, that is Transfer of Property Act. Transfer of Property Act. First of all, this act will came into effect in 1st July 1882. Effect on 1st July 1882. This act is having total section 137 with Chapter 8. The Chapter 8. Total 137 chapter sections and Chapter 8. This Transfer of Property Act will divide into four parts. First part is sale, second part is lease, third part is exchange, fourth part is gift. The sales topic is covered under section 54 of Transfer of Property Act. Lease topic is covered under 105 to 170. Exchange cover under section 118 to 121. Gift cover under section 122 to 137. Here, the fourth topic is described in this act. Transfer of property act means property ek person se dusre person pe kaha jati hai. Now the word property will be divided into two parts, movable and immovable property. But under the transfer of property act, the movable property is not defined anywhere. Movable part is defined under the sales of goods act. And immovable property is defined under transfer of property act 1882. Under section 3 of this act. Under this, the definition of immovable property is given under section 3 and said that it does not include timber, growing grass and grass, growing crops and grass. Timber means the things that it is attached to the earth, it is immovable property. But as soon as we take out that things from the earth, it becomes a movable property. Likewise, in growing crops, the similar thing is there. Grass, till it attaches to the earth, it is immovable property. After the ripping of that grass, it becomes a movable property. Two cases are given in your book, Santa Bai versus State of Bombay, and second case is Marshall versus Green. In these two cases, Santa Bai case describes the intention. If your intention is to cut that tree from the ground, then it becomes a movable property. If your intention is that not to cut that ground grass or that timber from the ground, then that property is donated as immovable property. Similarly, Marshall was again, if you have intention that the tree will be attached to the earth and the fruit will be there, full lagging way. Lekin jaise hi aapne fruits ko cut kiya, that become a movable property. This is all about the section 3 of Transfer Property Act, that immovable property does not include timber, growing crops and grasses. And two cases were there. Thank you. Now, our next topic, that is transfer. It is given that who can transfer the property? Who can be ready to transfer the property? Whether three person or these three types of person can transfer their property to anybody. Otherwise, they will not do the valid transfer. To having a valid transfer, or a person who is qualified to transfer that property, he must be completed the age of 18 years. Second qualification, he must be of sound mind. Third qualification, he must not be disqualified by law. Means not disqualified by law means he cannot have any legal background, or he cannot be any type of criminal, or the property must not be a pending property. That law will not be denied to that person to hand over that property to anybody. Law ki nazar mein wo vyakti galat nahi hona chahiye. That person can be qualified to transfer the property. Next, how many property can be transferred? So this person can be of two types, transferor or transferee. Transfer, the person who transfer their property, like main transfer the property to myself is a transfer or main aapko kar rahi hu, you have become a transferee. The two parties were there in the transfer of property. The one is a transfer and other one is a transferee. To whom the property is transferred and who is transferring the property is known as transferor. Okay. Now how the property can be transferred? The property can be transferred if it is amount more than 100 rupees. It must be registered. In your book, two terminologies given, tangible and intangible. Means, if the property is tangible, means touch kar sakte, like property. Like property you have to want to sell. that property is tangible. So above 100 rupees amount, that property must be transferred out by the registered instrument. But intangible, like bonds, share, which cannot be touched, that property must be registered. In any case, this amount 100 rupees comes over, that must be a registered instrument. Plus, that property must be attested by two witnesses. Two witnesses must be there. And the seal of the registrar office. Last and the foremost to become a valid transfer, aapne apni property kisko transfer ki, that property must contain the two witnesses ke samne hoga. Lastly, it must be seal of the registrar officer. Registrar officer se seal lagayega, then that property become a valid transfer. Okay, this is talk about how the property can be transferred. The two persons, then the person's qualification, lastly that property must be registered out. Okay, in the next class, next topic. Thank you.